Thank you, Ciarán Corda. Ciarán Corda, tánaiste, we all accept and know there's a housing crisis. And unfortunately, despite your government's best efforts and announcements and plans, this crisis, unfortunately, is getting worse rather than better. And research from the likes of Focus Ireland has confirmed that there's an overwhelming number of homeless families had their last stable home in the private rental sector. But they've had to leave as landlords are selling up, and an increasing number of property owners now accept rent supplement. Your government has already promised that families would no longer be accommodated in the hotels by July. Instead, families are even being told that emergency accommodation is not available. Today we learn that 12 families and 30 children were told to go to Garda stations on Tuesday night. Three of these families were recently evicted and presented to Store Street. Other families, with their children, presented to Pier Street and Clondalkin stations. These families were already homeless, evicted and presented to these stations. Other families, they depend on B&B accommodation and emergency accommodation on a day-to-day basis. The situation is bad enough, but unfortunately, Tuesday has brought a very negative and extremely worrying turning point, as hundreds of phone calls were made by Focus Ireland to B&Bs and hotels for these families on Tuesday night, but unfortunately for them, there was no room at the inn. Some of those families ended up sleeping rough that night. Mike Allen of Focus Ireland has said that what happened on Tuesday is unprecedented and shocking. It is over 3 years now since Peter McVerry described the housing crisis as a humanitarian one. There are 61,600 households that qualify for social housing, and one of five of those is on the list for 5 years. There are over 60,000 people in severe mortgage distress. 7,472 homeless people nationwide, and this number has now increased 32% since March 2016. And one in three of those homelessness, of those that are homeless, are children. 1,256 families that include 2,563 children in emergency hotel and B&B accommodation. In addition, there are 138 rough sleepers in Dublin alone. Hotels are now getting busy. The tourism season moves along. And this has very negative consequences for short-term emergency accommodation provision. Tánaiste, nobody accepts that this is normal. But what is the government actually doing to prevent this becoming the norm, as appears to be the case, in how homeless families are being dealt with? If hotels are booked out, what plans have been put in place to seek emergency accommodation?
Thank you, Deputy.
And has more emergency accommodation been sought by Dublin City Council on a short-term basis than is presently the case, as we witnessed as late as last night and Tuesday?
Thank you very much. Tánaiste.
Thank you, Deputy. The Dublin Region Homeless Executive has overall responsibility for coordinating the response to homelessness on behalf of the four Dublin local authorities, as you are aware. What happened on Tuesday night is unacceptable. The demand for accommodation that was experienced on Tuesday night, it was exceptional. It was out of the ordinary, I do want to say this, compared to 2017 to date. Now, what has happened since then? From last night, the 24th of May, Dublin City Council has more than doubled the volume of emergency contingency capacity that is available to any family that may present in an emergency situation. And quite clearly, Garda stations are not suitable places for families to be redirected to in any circumstances. But there is additional now emergency contingency accommodation for families, and that is providing larger accommodation units which can accommodate families of up to six persons. I want to say that last night only one of these new additional contingency units was needed to accommodate a family. At the end of March, a total of 870 homeless families were housed in commercial hotels and B&Bs in the Dublin region. Figures will be published later today that show a reduction in the number of families in hotels and B&Bs. I've spoken to the Minister this morning, and he has been very clear that he wants to ensure that what we have are supported family facilities and appropriate facilities so that families are in more suitable accommodation, and that he wants those to be in place by mid-year. Over 15 million is currently being invested in 8 new facilities that will offer appropriate services for up to 240 families. And that includes facilities for children, homework clubs, key workers and HAP place finders on site, and families being able to look after themselves in those places. Facilities at Mater Dei, Lynham's Hotel, Respond, Clontarf, Clonard Road, Ballyfermot, Dundrum and Coolock are well advanced, and the state is investing 4.5 million on the Mater Dei development alone. And outside of Dublin, there will be facilities that will accommodate 21 families in Cork and 18 families in Limerick. They're also being advanced, while in Kildare, a facility for 8 families will open over the coming week, operated by Peter McFerry.
Thank you, Tánaiste.
Deputy. I acknowledge the provision of family hubs that you've mentioned across the cities are a welcome development in recent months. They've come very late in the day, and I would hope the pace will be quickened in a way in which we will not see a repeat of what we've seen the other night. Because I remember 2 years ago when a similar situation arose, and the Taoiseach of the day was asked about the fact that the law wasn't strong enough in relation to the obligation of government in relation to the provision of housing for for homeless families. It's very clear in relation to provision for children. And the Taoiseach at that time said that it would not arise again, and there was no need for any strengthening of any legislation. And it's a damning indictment on him and his government that we're here 2 years later and the situation has arisen again and the crisis has got worse. And despite all the best plans and the best laid plans and announcements, the delivery of housing has not been what it should be. Rent pressure zones and the areas within them, we still see higher rents. The Help to Buy scheme has done nothing but raise prices, especially here in Dublin.
Thank you, Deputy.
Regulations and cost of builders is exceptionally slow, and social housing provision is wholly inadequate, and the rapid builds too have been woefully slow. So it's near time, after a year in office, having looked at the performance of government and the delivery of government, and now that you are at the crisp of where you will have a new leader at the helm, but maybe then you can concentrate on the job at hand and provide the sort of services and facilities and housing units that people crave for, and bring your focus to bear. And all of the sentiment that we hear expressed in relation to the recent weeks within your party especially might become a reality, because to date, unfortunately, it has been far from that fact.
Thank you, Deputy. Tánaiste, to conclude.
Well, Deputy,
please.
You know more than most the intense focus that there has been on ensuring that supply is developed in this country following the disastrous lack of supply in recent years, for reasons I don't need to articulate here. But let me say, first of all, in relation to legislation, Minister Coveney has recently indicated that the current legislation, which assigns legal responsibility in relation to the provision of homeless services, including the provision of accommodation to housing authority, doesn't require changing. And yes, of course, I accept there is an extraordinarily big challenge out there for us in relation to accelerating housing supply. But it is worth pointing out that Rebuilding Ireland has ensured that so many actions are underway so that we begin to see the kind of supply that's needed and begin to provide the kind of accommodation that's needed. And if I would just tell you that 9 months into the implementation of Rebuilding Ireland, there is a strong evidence that the focus on increasing and accelerating supply is starting to work. Planning permissions for 16,375 new homes were granted in the 12 months up to the end of December. That's an increase of 26% year on year. And commencements notice for over 13,000 new homes nationwide were submitted in the 12-month period to the end of February 17. And it is worth pointing out as well that there were 3,000 sustainable exits from homelessness during 19 during There were 3,000 sustainable exits from homeless nationally during 2016.
Okay, thank you, Tánaiste. Deputy Eoghan O'Brien, please.
Thank you, Ken Corlin.